I can get it gone in a blink. We can make a from the sink. He can make a call if you tweet. I can make a ball when I speak. Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands, cause of that we don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the money in the middle, boy, I just solved the riddle for this pound cake. Giggles, now I see fiddle all around me. He little, my head was on a swivel, he was pushing a rental. Ain't it coincidental, he ain't really talking money, who he talking to?
It's week 11 of the NFL, and we'll see Chris Olave. He's gonna be a busy man in the passing game. It's the Vikings and the Giants, next on Madden Football.
We're situated about 8 miles west of New York City at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Today we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the New York Giants. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Vikings, they've been the talk of the NFL so far. And now out comes Minnesota. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit, and they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team, Charles, that should be in top four.
I would agree absolutely with that. What coaches worry about, what organizations worry about, though, is overconfidence. They've been playing so well, and now they've had that extra time off. And we've seen teams come back off the open week and come out flat. So what a lot of good coaches do is they kind of game plan for that with their teams. On defense, they may blitz more in the beginning to get them going. On offense, they may go more up-tempo. Anything to get them out of that lethargy right at the beginning.
Sliding out of the pocket. Downfield, and he's got Olave. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. A gain there of 21 yards.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
First down, they'll go to the ground to 10. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And that's a touchdown, but hold on. There is a flag down on the field. We'll have to see what this is about.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Awesome.
A costly penalty there. A lineman got downfield, and for the moment, that cost him 6 points. They'll set up a throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. It's a gain of 34.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, if only they were all this easy, because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now a handoff running through the middle. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Tries the left side and finds Olave. That'll put him at 77 yards receiving for the ball game. It's a first down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. A great effort there. His 8th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Vikings respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
Second drive of the game. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms.
Yeah. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. And they'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And that's going to be another good run on first down. This one goes for 14 as he is eating him up here to begin the drive. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings. Two minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. Nice little juke. 4 yards rushing for him now to this point.
All right, Charles, you know, we've spoken about this offense plenty, how great they've been all year. 9-0 now, into the back half of the season. Super Bowl favorites, without a doubt. I think everyone agrees on that. What do you think is the thing that most stands between them and a perfect season?
I think it's themselves. I think it's their team, how they approach things, how they conduct themselves during the week, practicing, getting ready, and then going out and playing. Can't take your foot off the gas pedal at this stage. Doesn't matter if it's a week.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe.
Tyree Wilson using that athletic ability to make the play.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
Third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of eight. Hands it off out of the gun. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them and don't have enough confidence to make a play?
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 13 yards as the Vikings pick up the first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Out of the gun now on third down. He's got his target. That's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 15-yard line. Excellent play there on third down. Give them 25 yards.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. One back in the backfield. He'll get the carry. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Second and 9 now. He'll buy some time right. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Josh Palmer, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
He was able to move around and found some vision to throw the football. And how about how he ended it? Boy, he had some zip on that throw.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt to have an arm like that. And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs. And I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Start this drive out on the ground. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 23 yards the pickup there.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was a terrific play, causing a loss. As a middle linebacker, simple. You can either fill holes or you can attack them, as he did there.
Second and 11. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 26. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution, it's not just performance, it's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he's got the defense so much on their heels, got them looking at each other, who's going to cover this guy, and what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 26-yard line. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. He'll drop to throw. His throw incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Touchdown, Vikings! Chris Olave with touchdown number 29, two short of LaDainian Tomlinson's all-time record 31. And the Vikings answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And this one now not quite over yet. Still two timeouts remaining defensively. And boy, having that third timeout would have really helped. We got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. This a very important drive, and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
They'll roll him out right. They're able to find the open man. That's complete. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Escaping the pressure right. This will be caught at about the 3.
And he will have a Viking first down, and that should be the one that gets him to the finish line. Going for the knockout punch. They'll try and run.
He had to fight that time. Ran through one tackle, but ultimately he's only going to get back to the line of scrimmage.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And they would not be denied on the ground, powering it in just one play after they got stopped short.
And how about how many tight ends are on the field? Because in today's NFL, we think of the tight end more as a pass catcher. For this group, they tell them you've got to be able to run block to stay on this team. And they committed to it and got it done right there.
Somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission. They come out, they have the big second half, and that lifts them to the victory.
And Brandon, trailing at halftime, we always talk about teams making adjustments. You know what the best adjustments usually are? It's just executing better. Because the game plan you put in place at the beginning of the week often still holds. You don't have to make wholesale changes. Just have to do it a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the second half, and that led them to victory.
So for Minnesota, they keep on rolling 10-0 now to start the year. And they'll get another road date next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now in the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves.
I can get it gone in the blink. Money. We can make a from the same. Money. He can make a call if he tweet. Black money. I can make a ball when I speak. Rap money. Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty trying to come up on the bands because of.
You're rolling now, boys!
Run it back, and you see how I act. Then I laugh, feeling like a fatal heart attack. I die for that. I'm stressing about it. I think less without it. I'm a cat at anything that's in my psyche. Feeling myself high key. Running back, let me have it back. I'm a cat at anything that's in my psyche. Feeling myself high key.
Just like that, like that, like that. Told her maybe right back, right back, right back. Oh, yes, like that, like that, like that. I told her maybe right back, right back, right back.
Run it back, run it back. Told her put the money in the bag. Double that. Run it back, run it back. Told him put the money in the bag. Double that, double, double that.
Run it back, run it back.
Run it,
back.
Run it, run it.
Run it back, run it back. 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 Run it back, run it back.